wapendwa, Bwana azidi kuwabariki. Ni furaha kuweza kuwafikia asubuhi njema na neno la Bwana. Na siku ya leo ningetaka tuweze kusoma neno la Bwana kutoka kitabu cha John wa pili, Second John, chapter 1 na mstari wa 5. Ni mstari mmoja lakini it has a lot of weight. Neno linasema hivi: "And now dear lady, I'm not writing to you a new command, but one we have heard from the beginning. I ask that we love one another. As simple as that. Love one another." Sometimes hata katika kanisa, in dealing na wapendwa, we have made the church business to be the main thing. Singing, choir, sermon, everything. Na mambo tunafanya ni ya muhimu na ni mzuri sana. Lakini Biblia inasema, loving one another is the greatest thing. In fact, the Bible says, even if I prophesy, even if I give, we can offer sacrifices, we can do ministry, but kama hakuna upendo, mpendwa unayofanya ni bure. And today I can tell you that, anakumbusha hawa watu, the thing I want to remind you, let us walk in love. Let us not be consumed with activities. Let us not be consumed with the many things that happens in the church, and they are important. Lakini tusifanye vitu. Programs should be done and should be there because of people. Ministry is about people. The kingdom of God is about souls. And the only thing that matters more than anything else is love itself. Na siku ya leo I want to say, Jesus speaking on the same, in the book of John, chapter 13, na mstari wa 4, akasema hivi, mstari wa 34, John 13, 34. "A new command I give to you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another." Yesu akasema, after all is said and done, I'm giving you something new. Love one another. Na akaweka standard, the same way I have loved you. Jesus has loved us unconditionally. Because asingine tunataka kupenda mtu na kulingana na tunaweka conditions. But God is telling us we should love without conditions. Na anasema in the same way. And that five is what strikes me most. We can say, by this, everyone, by this, kwa hili japo moja, everyone, watu wote, mtu ameokoka, mtu kipofu, mtu kiziwi. The Bible says, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. Najua wapendwa, saa zingine tunafanya ibada kubwa sana na mrefu sana. And we may do this, but I can tell you the people who are passing by, they can only hear good songs and music. Lakini mpendwa, tukishikana hivi tuende mahali ushirika, tukashughulikie ndugu yetu mpojo mpendwa ambaye ni mgonjwa, ambaye ako na hitaji. Watu waone kuna mtu anajali huyu mtu. Dunia, majirani watajua kuna mpendwa, kuna watu wanapendana. Watu wataona Yesu. And I want to tell you, let us put this challenge back. Let love become the ultimate thing. Iwe ni katika huduma, iwe ni katika ushirika wa wapendwa. Let us not honor programs beyond people. And this can only happen when we love one another. And I want to challenge, it goes back to you. How much do you love your fellow brother? How do you ever consider them? Do you consider yourself more than you consider them? The Bible says, by this, the trademark of a Christian is not the big Bible that you carry. It is not the lengthy testimony that you give. The trademark, kile ambacho kinatambulisha mkristo, ni upendo. That is what marks every Christian. Because we are a product of love. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. And I can tell you, one word that summarizes God, what God is love. Na ni lazima na sisi tupendane. Mpendo, wacha upendo. Na Paul akasema tusikue na deni ingine isipokuwa deni ya upendo. Let's keep loving. Just love. We like judging. Judging is for God. Let's just love. It is not our work to judge. People may not be complete. They may not be the way you expect them. They may have their shortcomings. Let us not be judging them. Let us just love them and love them and love them. God loves you. I want to pray for you who is not born again. Bwana Yesu anakupenda. Hata kama uko katika dhambi na umetumbukia, Yesu anakupenda. Repeat this prayer after me. Bwana Yesu, mimi ni mwenye dhambi. Ninaomba upendo wako Bwana Mfalme, ukatawale maisha yangu. I confess my sins and wickedness. Forgive me Wash me the blood of Jesus Christ. Na Bwana uniongoze katika njia za kweli na za haki. Write my name in the book of life.